really grateful to Sonam for everything that she stands for. Also, as an actor, as a fashionista, as a glamour person, Sonam has become sort of a byword for glamour and style and fashion, as you can see. So, my first interaction with Sonam was this little girl who was going to her tuition classes, and I was like, Anil Kapoor has a very beautiful daughter. And I think she was reluctant to go to tuitions that day or something, but she was
always, I was always reluctant to do anything which is serious.
So all I remember is this very, very beautiful girl. Then she went off to Singapore and she went to Singapore and then she came back. Then I met her again at Sanjay Bhansali's house, where she had sort of completely blossomed, and she was talking 19 to the dozen while Ranbir Kapoor was shy and completely, here was Sonam sort of yammering to fill the air, talking 19 to the 1900.
I know you were taking my interview.
Yeah, and Anuradha was interviewing her.
Sanjay
Bhansali. So I think the perfect embodiment of fashion and style and films is Sonam. Movie stars have become fashion icons have become movie stars. So we have a fantastic merge of fashion and style, and that is Sonam Kapoor. So who else to grace our Filmfare covers and our Filmfare events than Sonam? Thank you, Absolute Elix, for the wonderful partnership and the sponsorship. It's been a great experience. The event itself was lovely and was very well attended. And it just shows us how most stars, I think Sonam sort of put the fear of fashion and style into every film star, that everybody wants to look beautiful and be well-dressed. I mean, beautiful they all are, but be well-dressed and, you know, the red carpet look that sort of Sonam brought to the movies. So thank you, Sonam, for everything. And thank you, members of the press, for taking time off and being here. And again, this was our second edition of the Glamour and Style Awards. We hope that we'll continue to get better and better with every event. So thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Jitesh. And Sonam, may I kindly request you to say a few words as well?
Nothing, I'm very happy to be here. I'm always happy to do any event with Filmfare and Jitesh. I think everything that they do has a lot of quality involved. And whether it's the Style Awards, whether it's the Film Awards, or anything, the interviews or the covers or anything. So I always take out and give special time to them. It's not only because, like they said, I'm a part of the Filmfare family. It's also because, like I said, there's a lot of quality and there's a lot of gravitas to whatever they do. So it's nice to be associated with something that has that much of depth and credibility, I think.
Thank you. May I request Sonam to now unveil the cover, please?
I'm dying to see this cover. I hope I'm looking the best.
Thank you.
Kindly raise your hands if you have questions. We have a mic right there.
Are you asking me questions?
Yeah. Since Filmfare is the first dibs on asking you a question, who, according to you, is a fashion diva and why? I mean, what is your definition of being a fashion diva, because you won the substance, the absolute elite substance and style award, as well as the most stylish actor award. So
besides
what?
Myself, I
yes, besides yourself, that's self-explanatory, no?
I think, you know, when you I think when you look at all, are you talking about yesteryear divas or contemporary actors?
Who? I mean, it could be Marilyn Monroe, it could be Bridget, for it could be anyone.
Honestly, if I have to look at people who are iconic in terms of style, I would look at like Audrey Hepburn. I would look at Jane Birkin, you know, Nutan, Katharine Hepburn, Madhubala, Meena Kumari. They all, especially Meena Kumari, Rekha, they always had this, they dressed in a certain way, and I think all of them were fashion icons, and that's why they're legendary, because people ape their style, ape their idea of what, you know, when you look at it, like an Amy Winehouse now, she has a particular style and a particular brand of the way she looks and the way she dresses. And I think most people who become iconic have a certain style and artistic expression of how they dress.
So it's this artistic expression that you feel which sort of sets one actor or one's fashion icon from the other?
I think instead of looking manufactured, when it looks organic and you have your own style, I think that's important, because when I came into the industry, I decided, I knew that I couldn't be what everybody else was. I would just make a fool out of myself. So I just decided to be myself, and that became fashionable. And it's when you have your voice, when you're just stylish, because you're just wearing what you feel comfortable in, that just becomes a statement. Because you have an individuality, and you enjoy clothes, and you enjoy dressing a certain way.
If I had to ask you to choose your signature statement, because you mentioned the word statement,
I think it's I think what is mine is very vintage and old world. On the red carpet and for appearances, but at home, I think I'm very bohemian, which is my personality. It's very bohemian. It's just bohemian, I think. Yeah.
How do you think India has taken to fashion and style? Because it's become like a zillion-dollar industry. It's suddenly, you know, it's become so.
A lot of the actresses are abusing me for it. They always call. I remember one actress, a very, very big actress, actually, telling me, Sonam, why do you do this? You know how much money I'm paying my stylist right now? I was like, well, I don't pay my stylist, it's my sister. Or I just style myself. I was like, you just have to be yourself. And there are lots of celebrities back in Hollywood who kind of style themselves if they have their, like, a Tilda Swinton and Cate Blanchett, Blake Lively. They have their own style, and, you know, it's very distinct. So I think that's what it is. But because as movie stars, we have such a huge say in what the market is going to be like, yeah. Whether it's in movies, whether it's the ads, that's what we get. You know, it's movies and cricket, right, in India. So we've all started dressing a certain way and started wearing makeup and stuff like that. So I think that's where the industry has grown, right? Yeah. We fortunately, unfortunately, in good ways and bad ways, set trends. So we have to be very careful of what we do and what we say.
Talking of distinctive or distinct, another thing is Neerja. So, you know, I mean, every actor has a process when they do a role, when they work in. How was the Neerja? But like, did you have to break yourself down completely? How was the Neerja process?
I don't know if it's a bit. I don't want to self-promote or give myself any importance. So I think it's just important to talk about Neerja herself. My process into getting into the role and stuff like that, I think, is irrelevant. I don't want to self-grandize, you know, in any way. So all that is completely irrelevant. I spoke about it during Ranjana and during my other films where I have a process and stuff like that. I use the same process here, but for me, it's important that people understand who she is and her story, because what she was extremely principled, and she always believed in doing the right thing. I did all this research on her, and I spoke to all her friends and her family and people who knew her, who worked with her. There are a lot of photographers and ad filmmakers, iconic ones, who worked with her, and her, you know, her crew members and the passengers and everybody. I spoke with them, and they all said that she was only interested in doing the right thing. And it didn't matter what it was. It was the principle of the thing. It was always the principle of the thing. And that is important. And that's what I learned from it. So it's not what I brought to the film. It's what the film brought into my life. What I learned was I was basically on shaky ground for a couple of years. I've always been known to be someone, I think, who has an opinion, who says the right thing, who always wants to do the right thing. And a lot of people are not okay with it. So there's a lot of negativity because I'm not compromising on a lot of things. And I was like, you know what? I'm getting backlash for being who I am anyway. I might as well become this person. But then this film came at the right time. And it taught me that a girl who was only 23 years old, she did this. She faced fear. And that's the most important thing, Jitesh. When you're scared and you still do the right thing, when you know that there's going to be something that's not right that's going to happen to you, but you're still like, it doesn't matter. And she did it on another level. She lost her life doing it. But it's a silly thing. Like, for example, going on Twitter and standing up for the right side. It's scary because you'll have a lot of people being negative. The media might not take it the right way. You know, you might have morchas outside your house. You don't know. But you still need to stand up for it. And I also feel being diplomatic and not taking sides is also wrong. Because at the end of the day, you're actually encouraging the person who is not doing the right thing. So by not taking a stand, according to me, is also not the right thing to do anymore in this day and age. Because a lot of negative things are happening in the world right now. So I always think you need to take the stand. You need to do the right thing. And that's... So I just inculcated that principle back into my system. Because I always did that. Because, you know, when you come in, you're young and idealistic. And that's why I think it's important for people to see this film. Because she was petrified. Anybody you ask in the plane, they were like, she was literally shaking and scared. But she always tried to do the right thing at that point. And so it was her fear versus courage. And her courage took over, which is in real life. And that's why people are reacting to it the way it is, because it's a biopic, it's Neerja, it's got me starring in it. It doesn't have it's not a big commercial film, and suddenly people are like, it's loving the pro. Just the promo is because people want to be this person. Yeah.
What a lovely thought. Courage takes over fear. Now I leave the floor open to other members of the press if there are any questions.
Hi. Thank you.
Sonam, coming back to style, you know, you are the true fashion icon and we all look up to you. But then, you know, recently you have been compared to Athiya Shetty and everyone says that, you know,
shouldn't it be the other way around?
I mean, Athiya is also compared to you and they say that, you know, she's the next style icon after Sonam Kapoor. So what do you have to say about that? Do you still...
More the merrier. I love Athiya. I think she's incredibly beautiful. And she's very sweet and I think she's very, she's like a gazelle, I think. She's very beautiful. Yeah.
Though it's too early to say that, but after watching Nirja's trailer, people are saying that it's going to be a turning point in Sonam's career. So what is your take on that?
They say that with every film. When will the turning point come? No, I think they said that during Ranjana. I think I need to give credit where credit's due. Anand Rai was the one who recognized me first, and that's where my turning point came. I've got Prem Ratan Dhanpayo, Nirja, I got the opportunity to work with Disney for the first time, all because of the success of Ranjana. And I had successful films. I had Delhi 6, I had Savari, I have I Hate Love Stories, I have an incredible filmography. But I do very few films. I do one or two films a year. And so people tend to forget that I've had successful films before. So Nirja releases and Touchwood, it'll do well. People will forget. And then the next film will come. And that might also, again, be my turning point. Yes, hi.
Hi Sonam, my name is Sonu. I want to ask this, according to you, what is fashion? What is style up?
Style is an expression of an individual, you know. You need to have individuality to have style. Being fashionable and being stylish are two different things. And style is just being able to carry clothes off no matter what you wear. You should be able to wear a bag and be stylish in it. Fashion, being fashionable is completely different. I hate it when people call me a fashionista. I'd rather people call me stylish.
It's okay, I can hear you. If you speak loud enough, I
can. Like fashionable clothes and all, we can become stylish.
I think it's...
There must be different qualities and all.
You have to have an individuality. You need to be yourself to be stylish.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. Ji, obviously dekha hai.
Unko kaisa laga?
Bahut hi pasand aaya. Unhone film bhi dekhi hai.
Superb.
Leke aapke upar, khas kar, kyunki puri film aapke upar depend hai ye.
Ye, I think meri panchvi film hai. I've done 10 films. Out of that, 6 films I've done which are solo films, six, seven films. So responsibility har film ke saath hoti hai. And, matlab, kaam to karna padega, par jab aap 100% dete ho, maine har film mein 100 ya 200% deti hoon, jab mera kaam khatam ho jata hai, acting ka, aur promotion ka, to mera kaam khatam ho jata hai, uske baad, bhagwaan ja rahe hai, aur log jaane. जी मैं ऐसे सोच के फिल्म करती नहीं हूँ।
One last question I have time for.
Hello, सोनम आजकल बायोपिक बहुत ट्रेंड में है जैसे रिसेंटली अभी बाजीराव मस्तानी आई और अभी आपकी निर्जा आ रही है सो व्हाट यू थिंक?
हाँ हाँ ठीक है तो मैं क्या बोलूँ आपको कैसे? Is it a trend? one or two films a year does not make it into a trend. There are like some, how many films in Bollywood do we have in a year? 300, 400? Out of that, two or three films a year. Anything that is a good story is something good to make. Content is king.